Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So till now we have discussed many topics like science of death, ergo mortis, livor mortis, rigor mortis, etc. Next topic that we're going to discuss here is the decomposition stage. After rigor mortis comes the decomposition stage. So in this video we are going to discuss about it. We are going to discuss why the body putrefies, the signs and symptoms, onset, internal organs, internal changes that we get to see, and the medico-legal importance. Also, if you want this PPT, then you could go check out my website. I've provided this PPT over there. You can go download it from there. The link is there in the description box. So let's get started. Putrefaction is a process by which complex organic body tissues break down into simpler or inorganic compounds or elements due to the action of saprophytic microorganism or due to autolysis. So putrefaction is simply breakdown of complex molecules into simpler forms, and this is done with the help of microorganisms that are saprophytic in nature. Saprophytic organisms are those organisms that feed on dead and decaying organisms, right? So basically putrefaction is breakdown of molecules. Then putrefaction usually follows the disappearance of rigor mortis. So once the rigor mortis stops, once the rigor mortis is complete, putrefaction starts. Although during the hot season it may commence even before the rigor mortis has completely disappeared from the lower extremities. So the temperature around the dead body is very hot, then there is a possibility that the putrefaction is going to start even before the rigor mortis has completely disappeared. Then this point is very important. Many times question has been asked from here. Prostate and the uterus, they are the last organs to decompose, and this is the reason why they can help us identify the sex of the dead body even in the advanced state of decomposition, right? Now let's understand why does body putrefy. So after the death, the body's protective functions are absent, right? And its defense barrier is lost. So now that these protective functions are not there, the body becomes susceptible to attack by microorganisms or by various physical and chemical agents. So the saprophytic microorganisms which cannot invade the body during the life, and the other physical and chemical agents that were not able to invade the or attack the body during the person was alive are now able to act on the dead body. Further, some body chemicals and enzymes which are helpful in different metabolic processes, in the absence of physiological control after death, they also start to act adversely. Now, the main microorganisms that are involved in the putrefaction process are Clostridium welchii, Staphylococcus, non-hemolytic Streptococcus, diphtheroids, and proteus. They are some of the important microorganisms. Then the gases that are produced during this process are hydrogen sulfide or H2S gas, phosphorylated hydrogen, ammonia, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, mercaptans, and methane. So these are the microorganisms that are involved. These are the gases that are produced. Next, we can talk about the signs of decomposition. So this first point is very important. Many times question has been asked from here. The first external sign of decomposition is usually a greenish discoloration over the right iliac fossa, over the region of cecum which lies superficially, and the contents of the bowel are more liquid and full of bacteria. So basically the question has been asked from here that which place can we see the first external sign of decomposition. So it is the right iliac fossa. Here we get to see a greenish color discoloration. Clostridium welchii are most abundant in the ileocecal zone of intestinal tract. Internally, this is seen on the undersurface of liver where it is in contact with the transverse colon. After death, when the tissue barrier is lost, they can invade through the intestinal wall and reach the blood vessels and produce H2S gas. Here they means the saprophytic microorganisms. The gas combines with hemoglobin of the blood and forms sulfhemoglobin gas, that is H2S gas. It combines with the hemoglobin of the blood and it is going to form sulfhemoglobin, which discolors the vessels and the surrounding tissues, so due to which the color of the vessels changes. If we talk about the onset, then in India this change is seen by after about 12 hours in case of summer, or even before the temperature is very high, and usually around after 36 to 48 hours in case of winters. The discoloration gradually spreads all over the abdomen, external genitalia, face, neck, thorax, and lastly to the limbs. In temperate conditions, these changes are seen in 24 to 48 hours after the death. Now, if we talk about certain internal changes that occurs due to putrefaction, the organs composed of the muscular tissue and those containing large amount of fibrous tissues, they resist the putrefaction longer than the parenchymatous organs, with the exception of stomach and intestine, which decompose rapidly because of their contents at the time of the death, right? Because there are food contents in the stomach which are more susceptible to attack by the microorganisms. Liver softens and becomes flabby in 12 to 24 hours, and blisters appears on its surface in 24 to 36 hours. The liver assumes a honeycomb or foamy or Swiss cheese appearance due to formation of air bubbles. It becomes greenish in color and later changes to coal black. Heart may show white granularity consisting of calcium and soapy material on epicardial and endocardial surfaces known as military plaques. As a general rule, the organs show putrefaction changes in the order that is given on the right here. The organs can be either there can be early putrefaction or there can be late putrefaction. So all these organs, that is larynx and trachea, stomach, intestine, spleen, liver, brain, gravid, uterus, they all show early putrefaction, whereas heart, lung, kidney, esophagus, diaphragm, blood vessels, bladder, prostate, uterus, skin, muscle, tendon, they all show late putrefaction. Now if we talk about the medical importance, then obviously it is a surest sign of death. From decomposition changes, time since death can also be assessed. In advanced decomposition, the identify of the deceased may be impossible. In advanced putrefaction, no opinion can be given as the cause of death except in case of poisoning, fractures and firearm injuries. So this was all about this video. I hope you understood the process of decomposition, why it is caused, what microorganisms are involved, what are the signs and symptoms, what is the onset time, what is the medico-legal importance. If you found this video to be useful, then please like this video, share it with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. Hit that bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you for watching.